What's up, guys? This is Dr. O, and if you stay tuned to this one, I'm gonna give you an idea of how to stay out of the dental chair and basically avoid seeing me. Isn't that weird? Why would I give an idea of how to avoid seeing me? I don't know, I'm gonna talk myself out of a business. This is a bad idea. I'm gonna do it anyways, you know? I think this will help a ton of people, and I'm pretty excited to talk about it. It's a question that we have all the time at our practice. Patients have tooth decay, they weren't even aware of it, and they're wondering, how in the world did I get a cavity? They brush, they floss even, they still have tooth decay. So the question would be, hey, is it the sugar that's causing tooth decay? And that's what the title of this video is about, is does sugar really cause tooth decay? I think most people would say, well, yeah, duh, sugar causes tooth decay. That's what I've always been told, is avoid candy and I'm gonna be pretty well set and I'm not gonna have tooth decay. Or just have one soda instead of six sodas. And you know, is this worse than this? Does one have more sugar? I don't know, this one's got 140 calories and 39 grams of sugar, and then this extra sweet tea, so we went all out. This is like McDonald's sweet tea. I don't know, have you guys ever had McDonald's sweet tea? Take off the lid and see that it like doesn't even move like a fluid. It's pretty awesome, it's like a gel. But this has 65 grams of sugar in this extra sweet tea. That's intense. And then the soda for one serving is 39 grams. So your argument might be, hey, soda's got more sugar, it's gonna cause more tooth decay. Plaque is bacterial mass that builds up on your teeth, and obviously that's why we brush and we floss, to remove that. And the more you remove that, the less obviously there is, and the better off you are as far as bacteria build up on your teeth. So we know that plaque harbors bacteria. Well, bacteria can't do anything without sugar, and consequently, neither can we. So it's obvious that we're gonna have to consume sugar to live. There's very few people that can commit to a diet that doesn't consume any sugar, simple sugars or carbohydrates. Those might be like the keto diet you might have heard of, I don't think has hardly any carbohydrates or any sugars that are allowed, and therefore the bacteria wouldn't have hardly any source of food in the mouth to consume and turn into lactic acid. But that's like the only diet, and it's very difficult for people to commit to that and live that way. So if you're like me and probably almost everybody else, you love sugar in some sort of fashion, whether it's a simple sugar or carbohydrates. We need them obviously for our body to work, for our brain to think, and so sugars are necessary. If sugar causes tooth decay, then we all consume sugar, then why don't we all have cavities? And that's kind of what I want to answer. And that gets us to our third component of what is causing cavities in our teeth. And that is time. Obviously, this has to amount to bacteria and sugar over time. And the biggest thing is not the quantity of sugar, it's the quantity of time that we have sugar on our teeth. And because that's the answer to what causes cavities, we need to think about the habits that we have. And ultimately, that's the biggest factor and avoiding tooth decay. Is it the student that drinks Red Bull to stay awake and study for his or her exam? The person that has the desk job and maybe goes to come and go or goes to the gas station on the way into work and they grab that big gulp and they set it on their desk and they maybe take till 2 in the afternoon to finish that drink? That's super damaging, because even though it's only one beverage, it's consumed over a long period of time. Therefore, the acidity in between their teeth is gonna be high for hours, and that's gonna cause a lot of damage to their teeth. You know, is it the stay-at-home mom that, because she's working so hard to take care of the home and the kids and take care of them, she's distracted throughout the morning, she's trying to enjoy her cup of coffee, but just can't finish it because the kids want this and that, and gotta take them to school and then get back home, and she has to reheat her coffee multiple times. That's a story I get often, is the stay-at-home mom or somebody who's staying at home taking care of the family is struggling to complete a coffee that might just have, maybe just creamer. But creamer has what? Lactose, and lactose is a sugar. And so it's broken down by the bacteria, turned into lactic acid. And if you consume that coffee over a 3 or 4 hour time period, you'll cause significant damage to your teeth. The point of the video is really to draw attention to the habits of how we might consume sugar. Basically the delivery method of sugar. The delivery method's the most damaging, not the quantity. Matter of fact, I could sit here and I could chug this entire soda and it won't cause hardly any acid to be sitting on my teeth for a long period of time. Yes, granted, it's acidic itself, there's sugar in it, the bacteria will use that. But after about 20 minutes when I'm done with the soda, my saliva will wash away most of the sugar that's there. The bacteria will have consumed most of it and it won't be breaking down into acid in between my teeth or around my teeth. Whereas if I were to take this, which is much less in quantity, right? I don't know, I mean, this is like 18 ounces. This is like 67 ounces. So much less in, as far as quantity. But if I took this same beverage, and I decided, you know, I'm working really hard today, but I need sugar every once in a while to keep myself awake and motivated. And I put this next to my desk and I'm just sipping on it. I'm giving a lot more sugar over time for those bacteria to break down and turn into acid. So that habit, if I did that daily, now once every week or ever so often, that's not gonna cause it. It's gonna be the daily habit. And so that's what I'm trying to draw attention to try to really help people to avoid going to the dentist with tooth decay that they're just shocked they have and didn't realize that something simple like the consumption of sugar over time was really what's damaging their teeth. All right, so you're saying to yourself, okay, Dr. O, I get it. I need to address the habits and the way I might be consuming sugar. I'm doing it over time. I go to the gas station and get that big gulp every day. I go to Starbucks and get that frap. I understand how that causes damage. I'm gonna stop doing that. But man, how do I stay awake? What can I do? What are some of the basically rules to live by when you're talking about consuming any beverage that has sugar? If it's something, kind of something I just think is kind of a common sense way of addressing it, if your coffee is cooling off in a regular cup, not a thermos, not one of these cool thermoses that keep it hot for like 12 hours, but if it's cooling off enough to where it's not good anymore, that would be a good time to stop. That might be what, 30 minutes, something like that. And same thing for something that's ice cold. So if you're having your soda and after, you know, the ice is melted in 30 minutes and it's just not really that great anymore, that's when you should say, you know what, I'm done. So really the idea would be 30 minutes or less, consuming it with a meal is best. That's how you might want to consider still being able to enjoy some of those delicious beverages without causing the same damage that the habit of consuming it over time, many hours preferably, would cause. And so hopefully that gives you some insight into some ways to live and adapt this consequence of maybe the sugar habit that you might have. Thanks for listening. I hope you found that the discussion about how the habits that we have with sugar is what truly causes tooth decay and that you found it useful and it keeps you out of the dental office. What am I doing? I'm keeping you out of our office. This is crazy. But it might be useful to you, right? You wanna stay out of the dental chair. I can still see you if you come in and see a hygiene and you don't have any cavities. We can still high five, have a good time, and then you can go home without any cavities to fix. How slick would that be? If you found this video enjoyable, definitely give it a like. Smash the thumbs up if that's something you're into. Consider subscribing, and we would love to see you in the next video. Otherwise, you have an awesome day and keep smiling. The daily frap, the daily cappuccino or latte that you might get at Starbucks. Dadgummit, I love coffee. I can't believe I'm doing this. I can't believe I'm doing this. I'm telling people not to go to Starbucks daily.